Welcome to this issue of iDrum Magazine. My name is Pat Garvey. In this, the second session on some essential styles material, we're going to look at reggae. Specifically, we're going to look at the one drop and the steppers type grooves. And we'll talk about some cross stick stuff and the whys and wherefores of all this anyway. The reason I've chosen reggae for one of these is because, quite simply, it's a completely different way of understanding the drums as a musical instrument. It's very percussive, reggae as a form of music for the drummer, and it holds many surprises. The first time I was introduced to reggae, my teacher said, go away and learn the Bob Marley's Legend album. It's really, really very difficult. And it took me years to get my head around it, and how Carton Barratt, in that instance, was playing things and thinking about things. With regard to the one drop, which is where we'll start, it's called the one drop quite simply, well, one theory is, because you're dropping the one in favor of the three. So you're emphasizing beat three of every bar. Which presents drummers with a whole host of problems if you've never really thought of things like that before, because most Western contemporary popular music, the emphasis is on the one of the bar. Even if it's not played, the suggestion is there. There's a really interesting classic albums on this, actually, where the producer was talking about getting various session musicians in to finish off the album, and some of them were completely freaked out about this whole thing about dropping the one in favor of the three and turning everything around. I just didn't get it. So let's start with that. What we're going to do is I'm going to talk about just four different hi-hat patterns to start with. You can think of all this in cut time, but I'm approaching this as more of an introduction to the whole style. So the first hi-hat pattern is just straight eighth notes. Okay, so I'm going to play straight eighth notes on the hi-hat. And I'm doing rather ridiculous impressions of the three. So when you're sitting there thinking about this stuff, that's where you need to be thinking. The second hi-hat pattern is the same kind of idea, it's just it's shuffled. So we're using the triplet, more of which we'll be talking about in a couple of lessons' time. Here's an example of what's written down for the second hi-hat pattern. Again, my impressions of where the three is. When you're practicing these things on their own, it's very good to count to yourself, but also to really think about where that emphasis is, especially with a new style like this. The third hi-hat pattern is like your kind of standard swing jazz ride pattern, if you like, but we're putting it on the hi-hat with an accent on the two and the four. So you have this. Fourth pattern we're going back to a straight kind of feel, and it's one of the ones that was in the introductory performance for this lesson, and here is that one. A slightly more percussive approach, if you like, that type of notation we've seen several times now in this whole series of lessons since the magazine started, actually. So if it's confusing you at all, just have a look back over a few past issues and you'll find all the answers you need. The first thing we're going to do is we're going to add We're going to add a bass drum on the three to each of those hi-hat patterns. So with the eighth notes. With the shuffle. With the third hi-hat pattern. And with the fourth hi-hat pattern. Now, I'm going to go over those hi-hat patterns again, but this time with a steppers style approach. Steppers also known as four on the floor. So let's call it that from now on. You're just playing a four on the floor. Four on the floor is when you're playing one bass drum note for each quarter note. So working through those hi-hat patterns again, starting with the eighth notes. The second hi-hat pattern. The third hi-hat pattern. Fourth hi-hat pattern. So that's our two bass drum patterns with the four hi-hats, the four hi-hat patterns. The next thing to think about is a cross stick. So we're going to start just by putting it onto the three of the bar. So onto the same note as where we're putting the one drop rhythm. So i.e. onto the three with the bass drum. And it's worth just talking about the cross stick thing quickly. The cross stick sounds much better when you turn the stick the other way around. So you're holding it up at the shoulder end. And as far as playing it on the actual snare drum goes, if you spread your fingers like this, instead of like this, what it does is it helps you control the sound of the acoustic drum. Because these things only do what we tell them to do, because they're acoustic instruments. So I'll give you an example. This one I'm going to hold like this, and you'll see when I put it on the snare drum that I'm able to control the sound. Now listen. Now I'm going to hold it like this and play the same note. A very different sound and a less desirable one, hopefully that's come across, than the former. If I turn it the other way around and play it with the shoulder, listen to the sound. It's just not as nice. So, the eighth note hi-hat pattern with the bass drum on the three and the cross stick on the three. Second hi-hat pattern. Third hi-hat pattern. Fourth hi-hat pattern. Now, of course, at the moment, these are just exercises. And they sound like exercises, and they're only going to sound like exercises unless you just listen to the records and just get out and play, find some musicians to play this stuff with. And this goes for all of these styles lessons. It's where you'll hear the feel, it's where you'll get the authenticity in your playing. You'll see that I've written out a few different cross stick patterns for you to mess around with. I've also written out two grooves. I'll play you those two grooves. So the first groove, up to tempo. The second groove. Elements of the second groove you've heard in the performance at the start of this lesson. I'll play that track again and you can hear it in context. Again, I've re-recorded that in the style of a Bob Marley song. And you'll also see in the notes, in the leader for this week, that there's some recommended listening of a couple of great standout tracks and great standout drummers for this genre. I'll play the performance again. I hope you've got a lot out of this and have a listen to some reggae music. You will get a lot out of it. Cheers.